In this video, we're going to study Urysohn Metrization theorem. It's again one of the most important theorems in topology, and it uses very strongly Urysohn's lemma that we proved in a past video. Before we start, let me remind you that you can support the channel on many different ways. You can either donate or become a member on Ko-fi. If you become a member, you get access to exclusive content. If in addition to that content you want to get merchandise, then you can become a member on Patreon. That way you can get stickers, mugs, hoodies, t-shirts, and more. But if all you want is the merchandise, then you can go directly to our store and buy the items you want individually. Let's start with this theorem. We have that every regular and second countable space is metrisable. So if you don't remember what these three things mean, then check out the videos we have on those topics. Before starting with the proof, let's see what the idea will be. We will be working with a space X that's regular and second countable. To prove that X is metrisable, what we will do is create a function f that goes from X to the 0, 1 omega, where the 0, 1 omega would be considered with the subspace topology of R omega with the product topology. We know that this space is metrisable, and so is this one. That means that if we are able to build this function f as an homomorphism, then x will also be metrisable. Now this function f, because it goes to 0, 1, omega, is going to be a function of many variables. It's going to take one element x and return a tuple of functions, let's call them f1 of x, f2 of x, and like this, infinitely many functions that are defined from x to the 0, 1. And so to build this function f, we first have to build this countable sequence of functions from x to 0, 1. And so how are we going to build these functions? Well, the idea will be the following. Let's say I have a point x0, and the neighborhood of this point, let's call it u, so u will be an open set in x. Because of Urysohn's lemma, I know that I will be able to find a function f from x to 0, 1, such that f of x0 is positive, let's say that it's equal to 1. So I want to have like a typical modified function that's going to have value 1 at x0, then slowly decrease, and then outside of this set u, I want this function to be 0. And the same, obviously, this is just a drawing. So f of the space minus u would be 0. I know that this function exists. This sequence of functions, I will get one for each neighborhood of x, and that sequence will probably not be countable, and I want a countable sequence to be able to build this function here. So how can I use this idea of grabbing a point and a neighborhood and creating a countable sequence? Well, that's when this is going to be of importance. Because the space is second countable, then I know I have a countable basis, and so I can in a way do this for deep elements in my sequence. Instead of just grabbing any open set, I'm going to focus on those that I know are countable. Now you might be wondering, why can I use Urysohn's lemma? Well, remember we saw in a previous video that regular and second countable implied normal. So with these two hypotheses, we have that our space is also normal. So this allows me to use Urysohn's lemma and get all these functions. So once I have the countable sequence, I will just define this function f. This function will be obviously from x to 0, 1, omega. And all I have to prove is that it is an homomorphism. Now remember that because we are in the product topology, we know that this function f will be continuous if and only if each of these f sub i's are continuous for all the i's. So if I create these functions, they will be continuous because Urysohn's lemma gives me a continuous function. And so I will immediately know that this function f is continuous. Obviously, I have to prove so many more things to prove that f is an homomorphism, but I already have directly one of the properties. Well, let's actually start with the proof. We said that we were going to take x0 in x and u in the topology, that's a neighborhood of x0. Also, let's call the basis bn for n natural. So I have x0, some open set u that contains it. Now, because this is a basis of my space, I can always find here some element in my basis. Let's call it bn. So let bn be such that x0 is an element in bn and bn is contained in u. But now, because our space is regular, we proved in a last video that there will exist another element in the basis that will be contained here, and such that its closure is also contained inside of bn, because we just consider bn to be any neighborhood of x0, and so in the middle between x0 and bn there exists another open set which closure is also contained in there. Now, without any laws of generality, I can suppose that this will be another element in the basis, because if I just grab any open neighborhood, I will be able to find another element in the basis inside that neighborhood. So let's just call this element bm. So because x is regular, we know that there will exist bm also in the basis, such that x0 is an element in bm. Bm is obviously contained in its closure, and the closure of bm is in bn, and bn, we already said, was in u. So I have this set that's closed, and x minus bn, because bm is contained here, these two sets will be disjoint, and this one is also closed. So I have two closed and disjoint sets in a normal space. I can use Urysohn's lemma and get that there will exist a function f, let's call it nm because of the two indexes that are taking part, that will go from our space x to 0, 1, such that f nm of this set is 1, and f nm of x minus bn is 0. So I was able to sort of find a modifier function that has value 1 here inside bm, and then slowly decreases to 0, and outside bn it will just continue being 0. It's a very poor drawing, but you get the idea. So I have these functions. Now, because I have this for each pair of elements n and m, I will have a sequence f n m. And this, obviously, n and m are moving in the natural numbers, so it's a countable sequence. What I'm going to do to make notation a bit easier is, because it's countable, I can just redefine all the indexes and just have one sequence f sub j with j in the natural numbers. So I'm going to work directly with this other notation. So now that we have defined this sequence of functions, I will define the function that I want to go from x onto 0, 1, omega, where f1, f2, and so on are all these functions in the sequence we just built. Well, this function f is an homomorphism. To prove this, we have to do several things. The first one was easy, and I already explained why. F is continuous. This, remember, was because each fi is continuous. And remember that we're working with the product topology. Now we have to prove that f is a bijection. So f is injective. For this, let's take x and y, two elements in the space that are different. Now x is an element in x minus y, and this set y is closed. This is because the space we're working with is regular. So x minus y is open, and then there will exist a function, and so there will exist some function fn in the sequence of functions such that fn of x is 1 and fn of y is 0. But then if at least one coordinate is different, then the function f will be different. And with this we have that our function f is surjective. Now to see that f is surjective, what we will do is define f tilde from x to f of x. This function is trivially surjective, and then just redefine f to be f tilde. So basically we're taking our function f and restricting the codomain to be f of x. And this function is obviously surjective. And finally, to prove that f is indeed an homomorphism, we have to see that the inverse is also continuous. For this, what we have to prove is that f of u is open. For u, some open set in x. Well, let's take set 0, an element in f of u. That means that there exists x0 in u such that f of x0 is equal to set 0. Let's take the index n to be such that the function of that index in x0 is equal to 1, and the function in x minus u is 0. This index obviously exists because of how we built our sequence. And so what we will do is consider the following set. W is going to be f of x intersection the pre-image through the projection on the nth coordinate, where n is this index right here, of the set 0, infinity. Well, this set is obviously open in f of x, because f of x is open, and the projection we know that is continuous. And we will prove that set 0 is in W, and W is a subset of f of u. And this will prove that f of u is open, and thus showing us that the inverse of f is continuous. Let's start first with this one. But this one is a bit simple because of what we did here. We took x0 such that f of x0 is set 0, and then we have this index n for which fn of x0 is 1. So because fn of x0 is greater than 0, then set 0 is an element in the pre-image of this projection. And so like this, set 0 is an element in W. Now let's see this other inclusion. For this, we will take set an element in W and prove that it's also an element in f of u. So set is in W and W is this intersection. So let's see what is the projection of set, This is going to be the projection of f of x for some x in x, and this is fn in x, but now fn of x vanishes outside of u. This is because of what we took here. We took n, the index, such that fn vanishes outside of u. And so the only option that we have is that x has to be an element in u, because z has to be here, so it doesn't vanish. And so if x is in u, then z is in f of u. And this proves the inclusion, proving then that this function is continuous, and so f is an homomorphism. Because f is an homomorphism, then we have that x is metrisable. Because again, 0, 1 is metrisable with the product topology. And then this finishes the proof and the video.